When we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
A seeker of justice, a voice of truth, and a dreamer of a better world, Martin Luther King Jr. continues to be remembered as one of the most influential human beings to ever exist. In numerous letters, speeches, and marches, Martin Luther King fought for racial and economic justice, as well as the advancement of all people. Although he was a strong advocate of nonviolent action, he was unfortunately the victim of violent intentions. Throughout his life, he suffered unyielding personal attacks, was stabbed in the chest, his house was firebombed, and was eventually assassinated at the age of 39. Dr. King played a pivotal role in ending the legal segregation of African American citizens, starting with the Montgomery bus boycott and eventually the creation of the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act. Not only was he the face of the civil rights movement, he was also a pastor, a humanitarian, and a Nobel Peace Prize winner. Dr. King has inspired millions through his elegance, his fearlessness, and his powerful message that still carries weight in our world today.
Dr. Martin Luther King was prophetic. He was a man of high intelligence who saw beyond, you know, just the physical of a person.
A lot of other activists, especially politically, they would use violence, which is why wars happen and everything. But he was determined to not, you know, create an even wider difference between people, but rather to bring them together in a nonviolent way and to change things without using force, but with using just logic and motivation and kindness.
He was just a person who stood for something, and that was the advancement again of black lives and all lives for that matter. And he was someone who stood for something, and he did not waver in his positions, and he also did not use violence in those positions. He used the words, he used kindness, he used, you know, tolerance.
What made Martin Luther King different, and what makes a lot of people different in the world today, is looking past the color and looking past social classes and past everything that sets us apart. I mean, everyone sees color, but it takes a certain kind of person to look past the color.
For me, diversity is everything. Diversity means different part of people, different idea, different life experience. It's because I believe everyone is, you know, unique. So everyone in the world is diversity.
It's about tolerance. It's about respect for other people's culture. So that can be ethnicity, that can also be race, that can also be sexual orientation, religion, or an even geographical area. I think a lot of people think of diversity as a black and white issue, but I look at it on a more broader scale.
I think activism is basically fighting a poor man's fight without getting paid for it. And what I mean by that is, it's basically standing up for all injustice, no matter if it's racial, you know, if it's sexual, it's biological. I think it's just standing up for and advocating for something that's wrong.
You have your opinion, you have your voice, you have to show people what you think, and also to fight for your idea and your right. When I come to America, I just feel everybody wants to have their voice noticed.
It's like a lifestyle, I would say. When I look at activism, I think of it as people who stand for change, people who promote change, people who have conviction in what they do, and people who have, you know, a different view of something than the mainstream would.
I definitely feel that Dr. Martin Luther King has affected us in our daily lives, and his teachings shouldn't be restricted to just Black History Month or restricted to just Martin Luther King Day. I feel as if these are things that we should be taught on a daily basis.
And for me, he's always been a driving force, using his sense of intelligence and his rhetoric to, you know, move people in ways that other people can't, and I just respect that. especially growing up as a kid.
Something that always jumps out to me is he said he wants black people, white people, and all people to sit at the table of brotherhood. And he also said, you know, he want his kids to not be judged by the color of the skin, but the content of their character. And that today is a message that has helped evolve this country, has helped move this country forward. And of course, we still have some things that we can work on, but for the most part, his teachings and his message has helped this world and this country be a better place.
Martin Luther King has more influenced my life through his principles. I'm part of the LGBTQ plus community, and the fact that my community feels safe and ready to go out and protest and feel like they can have a hand in certain political issues and talk about things that aren't necessarily the easiest to talk about and fight for what should be our rights, should just be rights for all people. The fact that we can do that is huge.
At Kent State, there have been tons of events where students have shown their voice and have been active. The group Black United Students got together and did a Ferguson die-in on Brisbane Plaza. And that's definitely something that really has stood out on Kent's campus.
It was beautiful. I think that was, you know, a very revolutionary act. There's also been protests, there's also been walks. The role of a college student, it is to believe in revolution or believe in you know, change and advocacy for, you know, for things that need to be changed.
For me, I think the most part of his influence is critical thinking. He teach us to think who we are and what we deserve to have. We question authority and we fight for what we want, for the life we want to have.
I believe that, you know, because of what he, you know, what he believed in and what he saw out in people, you know, better than they could see in themselves. You know, that's why we're all here today, and that's why we're able to share the same space that we are.
He was someone who was a great leader, someone who his influence still lingers today. He's someone that I feel is just one of the greatest human beings to ever walk the face of the earth.
Our nation will forever feel the impact of Martin Luther King, his voice, and all our voices who stand up for what we believe in shall be heard forever.
You just thank the Lord.